Ever felt like your computer settings are all over the place? You know, those pesky Dotfiles that control how your programs look and work. Sure, you might be using Git to keep track of changes, maybe even Stow to link things up, but let's be real, it's a headache, right? Sometimes things don't match up, and not every program plays nice with the usual setup. But what if I told you there's a better way? Enter Nix and its sidekick Home Manager. Now, I won't lie. Getting standard with these tools can be tricky. It's like solving a puzzle where the pieces keep changing shape. But there's the thing. Once you figure it out, managing your settings becomes super smooth. It's like upgrading from a rusty bike to a slick electric scooter. In this video, we're going on a journey together. By the end, you'll have a shiny new way to handle all of your program settings. No more scattered files, no more confusion. Ready to make your computer life easier? Let's jump in and discover the magic of Nix Home Manager. To get a glimpse at what Home Manager can do for you, take a look at this .config file list. Many familiar .files I previously handled with Stow are now magically linked using Nix store file. Unlike Stow, Home Manager links the file indirectly and keeps a pinpointed version of every change. Nix generation shows us why. With Home Manager, every run is kept as a snapshot in time you can roll back to. Kind of like a system snapshot or application release, Home Manager takes configuration to a whole new level by making it not only automated throughout, but also reproducible, with the ability to roll back at any point in time. Home Manager is also protective of the home directory, so if we're trying to link an already existing file, it'll fail with a warning and a few suggestions. With the new capabilities, Home Manager takes care of user management and their environment. This is my local machine, but this becomes extremely useful on remote environments with other neighboring users. For example, I can add a package under my user instead of using the global system flag for system-wide applications. I can add a hello CLI, for example, and after a short run, it's available to me. An interesting change is the log file added to the path I'm under .config and Nix Darwin. Also note the long string at the top signifying the current directory resolving to a symlink by Nix. The lock means that this path is not managed by my user anymore, but is taken care of by Nix using a generated path. The changes I will be making are going to be at the source on my .file directory. This is also in sync with my .files remote repository, which is open source on GitHub under my profile with all the changes you'll see here. Okay, we know what it can do. Let's head over to the docs and get started. Home Manager comes with a great documentation taking you from different installation options through examples and options. Pair the installation. While I went with the Darwin option, I'm using a Mac and wanted to port my changes to a recent upgrade I made using Nix Darwin. Check the video here for more on that. However, the road was clunky and I think the best option for newcomers is the standalone option, which I partially opted to, but in bits along the way that didn't fully went as expected with my local setup. Let's get started then. Since I've chosen my Darwin flake, I'll add Home Manager as an input as well as an output to the setup. Once set, there are a few important additions. First, I'll add my home directory for Nix to realize where it is. The backup extension is optional, telling Nix where to pick up backups from. Nix configure build users tell Nix to build users listed that are not currently in the system. Remember, this is the systems flag that takes care of my local machine. It's not Home Manager just yet. As for loading Home Manager, under my Darwin configurations, I'll add Home Manager as a module, mentioning a few important bits per the docs. The last of which is loading a local home.nix file. This is our Home Manager configuration. Let's load that and get to work. Upon first installation, Home Manager will create a .config/home.nix example file. This file is also available on the docs. While Home Manager can do quite a bit, we're here for the .files. So I'm going to make sure I deleted all previous symlinks on my .config directory made by Stow so that the system is ready to migrate over to Home Manager. So let's start and build the flake first. Since I'm using Darwin, I'll run my Darwin rebuild switch command and let it run. Again, if this is unfamiliar territory, if you're not a Mac user, don't worry about it, just follow the docs of other platforms. Or if you are curious, check out the video covering Nix Darwin in the description below. I want to take a quick break and thank the sponsor of this video. Ever worried about the security of your remote work setup? Today's sponsor, Twingate, has got you covered. Twingate is a modern cloud-based alternative to traditional VPNs. It provides secure remote access to your company's network resources, making it easier and safer for teams to work from anywhere. With Twingate, you get easy setup in minutes instead of days, you get seamless user experience across all of your devices, and enhanced security based on zero trust principles. Want to see how Twingate can transform your remote work security? Visit twingate.com to start your free trial today and experience the future of secure remote access. Twingate also offers a free plan of up to 5 users, perfect for small teams or to test the waters. Now back to the video. Once the flake is built, there are a few quite obvious changes. To start, my prompt is different. It has 2 lines. My git config is attached to the prompt line instead of the right hand side. This means that Starship config wasn't loaded. Now here's an issue I went to quite a bit trying to configure Home Manager through Darwin as a module. The system would not be able to find the executable for Home Manager. To debug this issue, the quickest way is looking for Home Manager under /nix/store and grepping the bin file, to which my current setup responds with 2 findings. This is another issue of its own, as grabbing one trying to run Home Manager with it results in Nix conflicting with 2 versions of the executable. Make sure you only have one, either by removing the Nix package or deleting it on your own. Once clean, Home Manager switch is your command to run the local setup. Let's get to the Dotfile configuration work. With stow, I had a list of sim-linked files and stow would just grab the entire thing and port it to the target path. I did add a few instructions using stow.rc file, more on that on the previous Dotfiles video. However, with Home Manager, things are way easier and more explicit. The first and foremost is .zshrc, which earlier I had to take care of because of the way my Dotfiles were structured. Here, Home Manager takes a direct .zshrc source and populates it with my .files/zshrc/.zshrc template. Now for the prompt. With Starship, the structure is different and will be taken from .config/starship path. The way to do that is by adding .config/starship, which will be created as a path and then populated by Nix. Running Home Manager switch and Starship is back to normal. One line, git options to the right, just the way I like it. Let's redo the entire list of config files to bring my tmux, neovim and the rest to life. A quick run sets everything up, and if we take a closer look now into home/.config, there's a list of paths now pointing at Nix derivations that are not only managed by and protected by Nix, but also function as a snapshot that can be rolled back. Another pretty cool feature of Home Manager is the ability to not only provide a source for .files, but also their contents. For example, let's take .nix.conf file on my home directory. There's no such file, obviously, and the reason for that is because I take my configuration for tmux from another path. But for the example, we'll use this. Let's populate home/.tmux.conf from Home Manager. I'll use the text method and provide a multi-line string, which in the Nix DSL is surrounded by 2 quotes. Home Manager switch and sure enough .tmux.conf populated with the contents is now available on my home path. This means you can actually list every content of every file for your .files within home.nix. Let's also demonstrate the home protection given to us by Home Manager. If I create even an empty .zshrc under .config and then try to create another .zshrc under .config using Home Manager, the next time it tries to apply the new configuration, it'll stop mentioning an existing file that's not going to be overwritten and provide some help with how to resolve the situation. You don't get that with other configuration options. Before finishing up, here's one of the best features of Home Manager, rollbacks. As an example, let's remove cowsave from my user local packages. Before home.nix was applied, I can still call cowsave, and sure enough, once applied, it's now gone. Now I could go back and restore it, but think of scenarios where a bunch of changes were applied and you can't be sure what went where and how, and you just want a glimpse into the past using Home Manager. Well, generations come for the rescue. Here's a list of revisions with their timestamp, incremental ID, as well as a full path. Let's take the full path from the previous run where we still had cowsay. Every generation has an activate script inside it that we can call directly. Calling it resets the environment, and Nix tells us it replaced path, changed the profile, and applied the differences. Cowsay is now available again. Naturally, the next run of home.nix will apply the written changes, overwriting the latest setting. Home Manager is smooth, but if you're a Mac user running on Darwin architecture like you've seen me doing, there's a very good chance you should watch this video as well to cover other operating system settings. And if you got here without going through the Nix basics, I also suggest you catch this video to get yourself somewhat familiar with at least the basic concepts. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.